Hello, welcome everyone to another episode of the Virtual Ninja Show. My name is Heike, and today I have Saar with me. Saar, welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Heike. Good to see you again.
Yes, Saar, last time you were on the show, it was about RDP telemetry. So whilst we're not talking about specifically RDP telemetry, I think you are still in that broader telemetry team. And what did you bring with you?
Yeah, so definitely telemetry is one of my main domains. So I'm constantly working on telemetry. And today we're going to discuss yet another feature that we are releasing for telemetry to enhance it and make it more complex than what it is. The feature that we're going to talk about today is called aggregated reporting. So basically, aggregated reporting is a new data layer that is provided on top of the existing layer of data. And what it does is we aggregate for a predefined time interval quite a lot of telemetry, and then we send one event composing everything. So if, for instance, I was executing a command line and I did it for, I don't know, hundreds of times, even thousands of times in the last 1 hour, I am going to aggregate all of it and just send it as one event if I don't find it interesting for detection and investigation, you know, in real time.
So this also means, of course, custom detections that are being generated by customers that are bringing back telemetry, all kind of telemetry that we pull out of the different entities. It's across all the telemetry?
It's not across everything. We mapped a few critical action types that we think are interesting, and we generated a couple aggregated report event to that one. So process created now has process created aggregated report, and same for file created, file renamed, file modified. And also we covered logon success, logon failure, and connection success and connection failure. So we mapped four main categories, which is process, file, network, and logon, which we think is critical to provide our customers with more complete view than what they have today.
Yeah, and especially it's all these, I call them like little events that are happening all the time, especially file events. I guess, you know, it's one process, of course, as well, that can be pretty quickly overwhelming. So how does it look like? Is this like a new tab somewhere? Is this where, do we need to turn it on? How does it work?
Okay, so to turn it on, you need to go to settings, endpoint, advanced features, and then you toggle on the aggregated reporting feature. You can then toggle it off. We provide like full independent onboarding and offboarding to this feature. Mm-hmm. So it looks pretty similar to any other event that we provide today. It is fully integrated into device timeline and advanced hunting like we usually does. And as you can see in the image in the screenshot here, you can see process created followed by process created aggregated reports. So in this example, I was simply running a task scheduler that was running repeated IP config command lines. And what you can see is that some of them were logged regularly, like any other event, you can see them as process created. But at some point, the EDR decided that this is noise, like it is repeating, it's not very interesting for detection and investigation. And from that point and onwards, these events were aggregated. So you can see it on the left side with unique events aggregated column that was extracted from additional fields, as you can see in the query. You can see that the first 8 instances was sent as process created, just like any others raw event. And now with this feature, mm-hmm. you get a completely new data layer for process created aggregated reports. So you can see that the first event is actually 992 events because 8 of them was already sent real time. So the remaining was aggregated into one event. But afterwards, as you can see, like the machine or our configuration decided that it's not very interesting. So we ceased from sending any additional raw events and we instead sent only aggregated events. So going forward, you can see that all of the process created aggregated reports, they are all 1,000 instances each. So at some point, the endpoint decided that this is noise, not interesting anymore. But we also would like to, you know, provide full visibility into it. So we just aggregated the remaining and then send it as one event.
So, and then as I see, it's always thousands, thousands, thousands. So it means every thousand times it will create an aggregated view. But you could click on that little arrow and then you would see all the thousands. So in case you're interested in what it is, you could still unaggregate, collapse or uncollapse.
Unfortunately, you cannot do that. The way that we have implemented it in the backend is that it is sent, like we are caching it on the endpoint, we aggregate it on the endpoint, and then we transmit just one event noticing like the number, because otherwise it was just the same noise as anything else. And we also provide not all of the columns that are available in the regular event, but some of them. So it's not exactly like a traditional events. It's a more, you know, compressed one, less properties. And it's not stopping at 1,000. So in the example here, I was just running the script 1,000 times, but actually you can test it, but it can transmit even thousands of them and really provide very good visibility into repeated activity.
Mm-hmm. So is there customers where you would say, I would not recommend it for them to use it because of, you know, specific network environment or activities that they might need to see in more details? Or is this something that we say, hey, no, because we really reduce all that noise and we would really recommend everyone to turn it on and try it out?
So I think this feature really targets the more mature, advanced SOC teams that we are working with. So if you are less proficient in MD telemetry and, you know, you are not very into how we reduct telemetry or optimize telemetry or configure telemetry, I think this feature is not for you. It can create more noise than you would need. But if you are an advanced user and you are already very familiar with MDA telemetry and you want to see more to help you enhance your custom detections and investigation and hunting and get the like complete visibility of telemetry, then I recommend enabling this feature. And it's also like, it's very performant. It doesn't do any harm to the endpoint. So I recommend enabling it if you can use it, like if you have the knowledge.
So I want to know, can this be used, I don't know, in advanced hunting, in custom detection? So besides seeing this aggregated, what can our customers now do with it?
Yeah, so like I said, we introduced new action types. So process created received like a new action type, process created aggregated report, and same for the other activities that I mentioned. So you now have new action types in the advanced hunting. You can target them directly and extract the number of unique events aggregated for each, and you can write your own query. If we can look at one example, actually, that I was taking from the field, one of our customers actually was writing a very interesting query where he tried to hunt for beaconing activity. So you can see the credit here. I want to give him the credit. It's Mehmet Ergin. I hope I said the name correctly. It's one of our customers. I was just wandering around LinkedIn and saw his blog. I think it was very interesting. So I recommend our viewers to also read this blog. And basically, this query shows how Mehmet is trying to locate beaconing activities based on the number of connections and the consistency of them over periods of times. So this kind of detection was not really possible before because it's really repeated activity that usually the endpoint finds, you know, noisy. So we reduct many of it. But now with this feature, you can actually write a query like so and start detecting something like beaconing activity for a network.
Wow. Okay. So yeah, this was awesome. And I think, Saar, you probably brought another example with you.
Yeah, I have a more simple example, but also emphasizing this feature and capabilities. So for instance, you can go query device logon events and look for repeated failed attempts. Sometimes in investigations or proactive acting, when correlated with other activities or alerts, or even in an incident, it may provide additional context into failed logons for specific users. So it may be coupled with brute force attempts or something that really sticks out to the eye, that it's not very casual. Something looks malicious here. So I provided also this example just to showcase also the capabilities. So you can simply query device logon events, look for repeated activities that are very large or consistent or very strange users logging into strange endpoints and use that.
So you already mentioned the aggregation on the endpoint. There is no performance impact on the endpoint. Does it, like, because it's additional data that we also collect, does it cost anything for customers or something?
Okay, so in terms of performance, I'm trying to be a bit more, constrained. Like, everything may have performance impact, but we tested this feature extensively and we did not receive anything unusual in terms of the performance of this feature. Already 10,000 customers enabled it. We have not received any escalation. So yes, we think it performant. That's one. In terms of the billing, so if you stream MDE tables into Sentinel or Splunk, you may notice some increase in your volume of events because, this is a simply new data, net new data. So it's not going to be a lot. We recently, like the average that we see on the backend is somewhere around 2% increase in the total volume of these tables. So it's not a lot, but it's noticeable and it changes between environments. So I recommend testing it in your environment. If you find it useful for you, find the billing fine enough, keep it. And if not, disable it, tune your system. Maybe you find something noisy going on that you can reduce and even reduce your billing going forward.
Yeah, I think also, depending on if they want to use it here in advanced hunting, they might not need it in a SIEM system. And I think, at least in Sentinel, I think you can configure what data will be kept and not. I think we had an episode on that.
You can definitely filter it on Sentinel, but bear in mind that this is coming out, like this is coming together with already existing MDE tables. So device process events, device logon events, device file events, device network events, they are all like it integrates into existing tables. So if you stream these tables into some SIEM solution, bear in mind either to tune your filters or just know that it's there.
I think it's important to make customer aware of it. So it's a new table. So I know that customers sometimes are worried if they now get like lose something or like something is not there anymore. I think you also had this question a few times. So what does this mean?
Yeah, it's a common question. The simple answer is no. Like aggregated reports are layered on top of the regular events. It's a complete new data layer and you're not losing anything for what you've already have.
Perfect. So I think we covered it all, Saar. First of all, thank you so much for joining again and bringing this new feature to the Ninja Show. For everyone out there, please try it out. Again, you go to the settings, endpoint, and then advanced features, and then there is the aggregated reporting. Toggle it on, try it out, see if you can benefit from it. And then, of course, you can always use the embedded feedback option in the portal to let us know what you think. Or also, if there is problems or anything, use the submit feedback and it will land at the specific tables. With that, thanks everyone for watching and I hope I see you all soon. Bye.